Hi, I'm Rob Queree and I play Jack in River. And I'm sitting here watching it for the first time, so this is going to be interesting. The beautiful stuff at night in the middle of Kiama, in amongst the valleys, it was absolutely gorgeous. It was freezing cold. I had just come back from New Zealand with pleurisy, and I'm out there in this fog, coughing and spluttering, trying to see what's on the ground. And there was a lot of cow poo and horse poo around, which we tried not to step into. But this shot here with the whatever they are coming out of the lights, that was just absolutely magic. We've been there for ages trying to set things up, and then all of a sudden this fog came across and somebody said, grab the camera, start shooting. And this is what you've got, something coming out of the fog. Wonderful. But now we're back in the house with me on my knees praying, and this is something you won't see terribly often. Took me ages to remember the prayer because they've changed it since I last spoke it, which was about 50 odd years ago. It didn't work. It might have worked for the character, but it hasn't worked for me. Here I am shaving, which is also something I don't do very often, but did for this one, left the mow on, thought it was good for the character. Oops, haven't paid the electricity bill again, damn it. See, half blind, misses all the stuff that's going on. This character was a bit immersed in his own little problems. He had this the girl to look after. He wasn't quite sure how to do that. It was all a bit much for him, the poor old thing.
Check the feed and the temperature in the barn, right?
That was also the bed I slept in when I was staying at Daniel's. A little bit of trivia there. Now, anybody who knows me knows this, that this is an absolutely ridiculous shot because I wouldn't know which end of a car from another. Here I am stacking there, getting it fixed. Actually, all I'm doing is whacking a spanner around, hoping that it looks professional. Here comes Leo.
Having trouble with it?
Yeah.
Leo I've known for quite a long time through various sites and things that we belong to together, but I'd never actually worked with him before, and it was really good to finally get to work with him.
How about I give Tony a call? Get him to come out. No trouble, I insist.
See how knowledgeable we look, looking into the engine? Yes, that thingamy goes on that doodah there, and if you twiddle this knob, hopefully it'll go. Nah, forget it. Let's just go and have a drink. That's it, off we go. I think he's still trying to save my soul.
Yeah, fine. Right. Yeah, she
that didn't work either.
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful countryside out there, though, on the top of this hill, looking all around Kiama.
I never asked for
what is it, Kiama Bay? Or? Shell Harbour. Yeah, Shell Harbour, that's right. It's on the top of this hill. I didn't realise there was kind of green rolling hills like that around so close to us. Beautiful spot.
I believe you knew his father quite well.
Middle of winter, of course. Well, almost the middle of winter. It was the middle of winter, wasn't it?
No one really knows.
Middle of June, yeah. Freezing cold.
No other cars about.
But we look like we're warm as bugs and rocks.
No. He confirmed he wasn't.
Fortunately, it wasn't blowing too much that day.
You don't think he did it on purpose?
No, don't. Can't remember what we were talking about, but it must have been tense.
Nothing more. Young Scott may not have been a regular in my services. His parents surely were.
I think he's still trying to save my soul, but
it's
past that. Give up, Leo. It's not going to work.
Yeah. For a little while. What are you trying to... Now, I'm not trying to imply...
This character being a typical priest, kind of trying to stick his oar in and tell us how to run our lives.
We don't want any more tolerators. There are a few reports that some of the young people skipped out. But time, some say for good. The youth today are confused, and without the Lord, they are in need.
Nothing much else to say about this. Because the only problem here is while I'm doing this, I haven't seen the film yet, and I can't hear the sound. So I'm not quite sure what we were talking about. I can't remember. It's so long ago. Oh, that's all right. Here I go, back to fixing the car. Shake your head, Jack. Shake your head. You don't know what that bit does. Get your hand out of there. Here she comes, the mysterious river. Has she been possessed, or is it something else? We're not quite sure. Strange demons this girl has in her head. Real or imagined, who knows? Yes, you should get that wax out of your ears, Chloe. I might be able to hear the instructions better. Oh, heavens. She's having a bad day here. One of the many she has. Poor old Chloe, I think she had a bad throat to start with. By the time she'd finished this with all the screaming and crying, she had a worse throat. There's something else for people who know me that they would say, how do you do that, Rob? You don't smoke. Well, just part of the actor's art, really. Oh, there we go.
How do you know that?
Notice I don't smoke it all that much. It's all for show. Nice little scene between the two of us, I thought, this one. I enjoyed doing it with her. The scene, that is. And again, that beautiful old house on top of the hill with a 360 degree view. Some power lines, always riveting. Shot this one. Sun through the blinds on the wall. Looking good. Uh-oh, something's behind the door. She's about to have another one of her bad days, I think. Thank you.
River.
You all right?
Fine.
Come on. We're going to be late for church.
I ain't gonna put my land up.
Well, is that, it's just the future.
It's not the future, it's the end. It's the end.
Well, you ask the pastor.
Oh, it's a tragedy if you ask me. I mean, the answer should be all in here, nowhere else.
Well, who did I only build those homes for?
Oh, I've got no idea who they're building them for to it. And if we take some faith in this, we'll be all right.
You ever see a preacher down at Lakesview? She came out from Bible studies. She heard voices coming out of her computer.
And that gentleman there has the local Mexican restaurant, I believe, this big fella. And unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to go and try out the fare, but next time we're down there. Boys have had their chat, so they're off into church now.
And like a great fireball, Lucifer descended from heaven.
There he is, the fire and brimstone man.
Where he would forever remain.
I think the real minister was in the audience when Leo was doing this, and I think he might have picked up a few tips on what to do at the next sermon on the Sunday.
In the Lord. Do I hear an amen?
Go to it!
Demon before he even speaks into our ears. We must not let him even breathe a breath into our lives. Amen?
It's going straight over Jack's head, obviously. He's just not taking any notice.
Be banished from our lives!
Beautiful little church with some of the real congregation stuck around to be the extras in it, which was good of them. You've got to get some new batteries for that hearing aid, that bloody humming all the time, it's terrible. Mind you could turn it down when this was on, that'd be good. Now, I had to manhandle Chloe here. I didn't enjoy that, a poor little thing, but, you know, a bit of rough stuff. Some brilliant lighting work there. I must say, I enjoyed working with the crew. They were all great. good fun guys. And you can pay me that money later. You told me to say that. All seemed to know what they were doing. Seemed to. Maybe they didn't, but they seemed to. It certainly looks like it when you look at what's on screen. The lighting and the cinematography is very good from what I've seen so far. It's lovely stuff. Get some of that beautiful scenery in. Look at it. Now that I can do. Drink scotch and coke. In fact, that was only coke. Bastards wouldn't pay for the scotch. What's my next line? I'm thinking, what the hell am I going to say next? See, not only have I not paid the electricity bill, I haven't paid the TV license either, so that's not playing properly. That's for the old days when we used to have TV licenses. Looks like the cops are coming to get me here, but I think it's those funny visitors again. But she's gone. Every time the flashing red light comes, she's off like a rocket. She must grow very tall weeds in this place. They're as tall as I am, that one. Oh, now this was good fun. At the railway crossing, yes. Daniel said, let's go down and do this at the railway crossing right by Shell Harbour Station. Well, of course, it's a very busy little station with cars going in all directions. So we couldn't actually shoot there because it was too noisy and we couldn't get across the road because of the traffic. So we went up just around the corner of this little siding and got some really good shots. This train just happened to come along at the right time while I was on the other side of the road. So I thought, oh, I hope he's got the camera on the other side. We'll do a bit of dramatic stuff here and rush across as soon as the train goes. Here I go. Yes, make sure there's nothing coming. So that was more or less a one take, first take. I think there was another train came a bit later, wasn't there? But it wasn't quite as spontaneous. These are just little things that happen sometimes when you're doing films that really work out well. The mistakes or the little coincidences of things that happen. There's that lighting again. I love the lighting in this film. It's really, I really, really want to see this on the big screen. It's going to look like magic. Unfortunately, the wonderful cameraman had the sense to actually turn it on, even though we weren't planned for it.
Well, there's nothing wrong with it. Everything's fine and dandy.
So what's causing all this disruption?
Oh, well, got any base stations nearby?
The nearest one's about 90 k's away.
Yeah, well, it could be radiation.
Radiation?
Yeah, solar radiation.
That wouldn't cause all these outages.
Oh, yeah, you get one of those big solar flares and they'll knock out just about...
Really sounds like he knows what he's talking about, doesn't it? But he doesn't.
Sometimes they last for...
He's just an actor.
Even months? Oh,
another one of the locals who came out for us. Really good.
How's she doing?
I'm sure they're going to be really happy when they see it down there too.
She had a lot of a spook the other day in church. Mrs. Greaves says she's been listening to too much rock music. she'll settle down one of these days.
Again, you can see a bit of fog in the background. This was
this guy going around town and getting...
It wasn't really early morning, was it? It was kind of morning-ish, but there was still a bit of fog around. It was a bit cool on top of the hill.
Mini Mart or a factory or something.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah. See ya.
Yeah, right.
I tried to get him to climb that big pole, you know, for some authenticity, but he wouldn't have it on. Wuss. There's me waiting for the phone to ring. Not quite sure why. Oh, that's right, I'm supposed to be guarding her, but I'm nodded off reading the Bible. Well, I can understand that, but... Yep, here come the lights again. Off she goes. Was this a late night one? Is this one we... Yeah. Fortunately, the crew happened to stay awake and get these shots, which again are looking really nice with that lighting. Do I hope the lighting guy's going to buy me a drink after all these lovely comments? Told her not to shave her legs, she just cut herself. Now this was in the middle of the road, in the middle of the night, in the middle of winter, with Chloe in just a little nightie. She was freezing. You can see the steam on the breath there. It was absolutely freezing cold. And I believe I heard from one of the crew that a couple of cars were going past and giving them strange looks and wondering what was happening with this poor girl in the middle of the road. Wake up, Jack.
Hello.
Too late now, mate. She's gone. Yeah, that was, we were shooting at the little church at night, and obviously somebody had forgotten to tell the choir who were practicing next door that we were coming in to shoot, so we got all this beautiful music while we were doing the shots. Tough looking bugger he was.
Stay out of our way, go on.
He was actually a pussycat, but he was a tough looking bugger.
You know, you're always present in the house of the Almighty.
Was that when we did day for night, or was that actually a night?
Please let him get me. I'm afraid.
Was there anything that happened? This is like 2 months ago, and my poor old memory is not what it should be, so I can't remember some of this stuff. And I've done 8 films since then, believe it or not. Shadows on the blind, who went past the window, they'll never know. Ah, it was the salesman, that's right, the estate man coming to try and get me to sell the house. Some of that beautiful scenery again. Can't stress how beautiful that is. If you want to make a film with some lovely scenery, that's the place to do it.
So much space. Must be a lot of looking after. So much potential.
You mind telling me what you're doing on my land?
So much space.
Typical estate salesman, yeah, real estate salesman. They never answer your questions.
Troubled times, my friend, troubled times.
I manage.
I'm sure you do.
But just imagine all this, if it could be something greater. Imagine all this revolutionised. Down there, a small housing complex. Over there, a new shopping mart. Over here, the local town centre. You could give people new homes, new lives down here. The community would grow and flourish. This could be a beacon
for the rest of the community.
I agree with him, actually. You know, forget all this old crap. Bulldoze it down, put up some new stuff, cut up this beautiful big blocks of land, and give everybody a bit of 400 square metres of land and put a little house on it.
We're here to help you, niece.
What are you doing?
I told you, Jack, I do not want the devil to take our town.
Come on, what the hell's going on?
Ah, now we come to an interesting little part, the exorcism. Leo was getting it off tying the girl up. I'm trying to get him away. Typical priest. Buggers. Jerry goes, drags me down the hall by the ankles. We had to do it so many times because the cameraman couldn't get it right. Bloody hopeless he was. Ugh. Next morning, I had bruises all over my ankles. Broken nose from the foot because he didn't judge it right, but never mind. We suffer for our art. The crew were wonderful. I had to say that because Daniel keeps telling me to say that. Daniel's poor mum was wondering how the hell I was coping, being dragged down the floor umpteen times in the middle of the night. I said I'm used to it. My wife does it all the time.
Thank you.
This is me pretending to know what I'm doing again. Out in the garage. Tools in hand, fixing this, fixing that. This little ladder actually only had two legs. When I stood it up the first time, it fell over. A bit like me after the last night party. But... nice silhouette shot, beautiful.
There are no demons here.
What about all those people that have gone missing? And 2 weeks ago, that told the host.
What do you want from me, mate?
Oh, I stopped talking there for a while because I was actually watching the scene. It's just not bad. Looks good, sounds all right. Some brilliant acting from the man in the long coat. The other guy's okay. Quite intense. So there we are. We did about umpteen angles in that, and I think you've used 2 or 3, but that's all right. That's filmmaking.
Give me strength, O Lord, for I know thou art me protecting, coming, comfort me in time of need. Give me strength, O Lord, for I know thou art me protecting, coming, comfort me in time of need. Give me strength, O Lord, for I know thou art me protecting, coming, comfort me in time of need. Give me strength, O Lord, for I know thou art me protecting, coming, comfort me in time of need.
Listen, I gotta go away for a few days. Something's come up. I'm gonna have Graham bring Natalie over. You two seem to be getting on pretty well. You can look after each other. I won't be long.
Lamps look like tiny balls of light. And they cover everything like a warm blanket. It's oranges and reds and purples and greens. And they're scattered like a starry sky or a small carnival. Cars to trucks. To the little rocks in the walls, to the shadows that line up the vehicles. It's like seeing your first Christmas or the first little candles in your birthday cake, because they don't flicker, move, or dwindle, they just remain constant.
Was that smoke or steam on the breath again? Must have been freezing again that night. Again, I haven't seen this scene, so I'm thoroughly enjoying watching it here. Nothing really to comment on. These two girls doing a lovely job. It's Daniel sneezing in the background. That's because I can't remember the lines.
I can't say. I can't tell anyone.
It's okay. Father Gore fixed you.
And you can trust me, we're bestest friends.
You promise you won't tell anyone?
Of course I promise.
Demons.
Demons? What did they look like?
I can't tell anyone. The skin.
What would they want with you? You were baptized. I thought that...
I think they just wanted to harm me or something.
But Father Gore said that if you believe in God, then you can...
He won't know if I believe it anymore. I mean, I just can't remember the last time he was with me. It's like he's left me or something. It's like the one time Mum forgot me in the store. I waited for like an hour. I was like four or so, but I remember waiting all day. And it wasn't until the sun came down that a car pulled up. He must have had a lot on my mind, that's all. Been busy.
River, you have to be strong, you have to have faith. God hasn't forgotten about you, he's merely testing you, that's
testing?
All.
Testing?
Yeah, just like he did with people like Joseph and Moses.
Yeah, but I don't think I'm as strong as they are. And besides, what does God want from me?
He loves you. He loves you, he loves everyone. And you've got me, River, I'd do anything for you.
Jack!
I've got to leave.
You got to what?
I've got to go.
Why? What is it?
I've got something to show you. It's very rare. Look, you feel the sharp edges around the corner, and they're dark purple. And if you bring it towards the light, it makes everything go purple. And here, it's a blue stain. One day I was pretending to be a scientist, and I was playing with food coloring, and I thought I could.
What? River? Who's come? He's come. What's going on, River?
The demons.
What? No, River, it's okay. River? What's going on?
Some lovely fake blood there from the makeup person. Do we have a makeup person?
No.
No, we didn't have a makeup person. I think it was everybody makeup the makeup. So, yeah. What have you got that's red? Oh, some raspberry cordial. Mix it up with a little something to make it thick. Melt a bit of lipstick. Looks all right, though. Here we are back out in the Kiama wilderness at night again. Freezing cold. This was before the fog came up, so you can see how clear it was then. And then the shot at the beginning with all that fog, it just came out of nowhere. It was like amazing. It was like the aliens were actually landing.
Treated many schizophrenics in my time. We can't help you, River, just let us in. Now, I want you to do something for me. I want you to imagine you're in a forest. There are trees all around you. There are no animals or people, just you. You can't see much, but you can hear the sound of the wind blowing through the trees. Can you imagine that for me?
So, as I'm not in the last few minutes, I'm not going to bother commenting anymore. So, that's my commentary on the film. I had a thoroughly enjoyable experience on it. One of the best, most enjoyable shoots I've done in a long, long time. And I've done a lot lately. Can't wait to see it finished and can't wait to see it on the big screen. But by the time you're listening to this commentary, of course, it will be finished and will be on the big screen. So that's totally irrelevant. Anyway, yeah, I enjoyed it. Hope you do.
Fine. Open the door. Maybe tomorrow you decide that there's no place for such a person as yourself. You need to have faith, otherwise you'll be lost forever. Still feel not in the mood to cooperate?
Trust you.
Good. Let's begin. You believe these demons are real?
Yes.
And what is it you think they want with you?
I don't know.
Tell me more about Natalie.
She was my friend.
Good friend?
Best friend.
And what happened to her?
Trying to protect her.
Protecting her from them.
I wanted us both.
And you didn't want anyone to take away from you.
No.
These voices, these sounds, what do you think they are telling you to do?
I don't know.
I think you do.
I can't talk about these.
Yes, you can. Yes, tell me what they want you to do.
Give me the strength of another arm, protect me, guide me, cover me, stamina. No.
These creatures, these demons, they're not real. They're merely constructs of your mind. They do not exist.
Yes, they do. They do exist.
Don't.
No, they do.
What you experience in your intense episodes, we can help you, but you must come to realize that these creatures do not exist.
Yes, they do. Give me the strength of the Lord, for I know that I'm a protect me, guide me, cover me, stamina.
River, they're not real.
You know, he's left me. God, he's left me.
I don't believe.
I don't believe.
looking at me. The next day, the day after that, I will keep going until you realize there is nothing for you to be worried about. There's nothing to be scared of.
Thank you.